Hi, I'm Chris Berman. Ahead on ESPN, it's time to head under the bubble in Indianapolis. The Big Horseshoe is where we'll find Dan, Peter, and Susie. They get set to bring you what looks like a good matchup. Buccaneers, Colts. This ought to be good. Indianapolis.
Well, the fans definitely look pumped up and ready for today's game. Hi there, everybody. I'm Dan Stevens, and welcome to the RCA Dome. Peter O'Keefe is next to me in the booth, and Peter, we've got a couple of offensive powerhouses down on the field.
No doubt about it, Dan. We could be in for a high-scoring game today.
Number 36 is just a great all-around running back. He's got speed, vision, jukes, power, and a little bit of everything. Tell you what, Dan, his teammate isn't too shabby either. Number 33, he's a receiver who has unbelievable speed. This guy's built like a 67 vet. He takes off, he's on the horizon before you can blink. A talented duo to be certain. It just might make the difference out there.
Well, all right, Peter, we'll keep our eye on him as the game progresses, but first, the coin toss. Gets the signal, and we're set. Number 6, off to begin the game. Number 35, downs this in the end zone for a touchback. The Colts offense takes the field, and they will start at their own 20-yard line. Number 36 has his number called on first down and rambles for about 5.
Second and 5. Ball at the Colts 25.
Number 36 gets the call again and picks up a couple. Third down, 3 yards to go.
With the tackle.
Number 34 catches it over the middle, and they convert on third down. Number 19, throw after the play action fake, and it's tipped, incomplete. Number 33 gets the sack way back at the 32.
Number 33 gets the sack deep in the pocket. That's going to be a sizable loss. Watch this. Oh, yeah. That's going to push them back way back. Great defensive play.
They read that play the whole way, and they force a third and very, very long.
Monstrous D the past few downs for these guys. Well, Dan, we got an empty backfield, 5 receivers, and the defense is in their dime. Let's watch.
Number 19 throws a heater and caught. However, it's short of the markers. It'll be fourth down.
Washington managed to take him down just before he got to the marks.
The defense let them get a bite of yards, but there's still a lot left on their plates.
I don't think they have an appetite to allow a conversion here.
Touche. Fourth down ahead. Lee lines up for the punt. Lee takes the snap and pummels this one deep. Number 46 fields the deep punt at the 17. Tackled at the 26.
Number 46 returned for a few there, but after that gigantic punt, it was like tearing a single page out of War and Peace. It doesn't make much of a dent.
The Buccaneers will start this drive at their own 26-yard line. Up a yard on the play, and that will bring up second down. Peter, once he closes his grip around you, you are not going to get free, regardless of how evasive you are.
Not with that strength. With those guns, he could probably juggle bowling balls, or wide receivers, for that matter. And a bunch of receivers out there. Defense is expecting that, and they go to nickel.
Hilton gets the sack at the 24-yard line.
Hilton does a great job stopping the quarterback cold in the backfield.
They lose a couple of yards, but it's the feeling of dropping the quarterback that matters.
Right. It's so important to stop and appreciate the little things, like a flower or a rainbow or
All right.
Tortured face on a quarterback, for crying out loud.
Nice job eliminating forward progress on that play. That will bring up a third and long.
Hilton made the save, dropping the ball carrier before he could get to the markers.
He's got such a vice-like grip, Peter. It's got to be hard to break out of his grasp, even when you're one of the slipperier runners.
Absolutely.
Number 16 lines up to punt after the three and out. Number 16 takes the long snap and pummels this one deep. Number 30 takes it at the 20. Brought down at the 34.
Number 30 got pinned deep by a beauty of a kick there, and by the time he looked up, there was nowhere to go.
The Colts stalled early last drive, and we'll have to wait and see what happens here. They'll start at their 34-yard line. Number 19 throws a bullet here, and the catch is made. The markers for a first down.
Number 88 doesn't let a little thing like double coverage stop him from snagging the football.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and they will move the chains.
And let me tell you, Dan, hearing those chains move is one of the best sounds in the game for an offense.
Number 71 sacks him back at the 49.
The Buccaneers send in three guys. Everybody else is back in coverage, and they still get their man. Nice play. Watch this. Well, it looks like
fleeted. They put a stop to this play behind the line of scrimmage. Pretty good call by the defensive coordinator.
Agreed, Dan. They had it all locked up.
That will bring up second down. Number 19 zings it to the right side, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Number 33 got himself in prime position to bat away that football before the receiver even had a shot at it.
On second down, they for the first, but it's played well by the defense. That will bring up third down.
Nice pressure that time.
Third down, empty backfield. Jefferson makes the catch on the right sideline, and they get the first on third and long.
Jefferson does a great job here battling three defenders. It's definitely worth a second look. Let's watch. And he still comes up with a ball. Wow, you can't coach that.
Third and long, and they get the big play to convert. What do you think of that, Peter?
I love it. That's what football is all about, making the big plays when you need to, and you can't coach that.
Number 36 picks up about two, and that brings up second down.
Number 36 used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
Number 33 didn't haul that one in, and it falls incomplete.
White closed in from the zone and forced the incompletion.
Third down from the shotgun.
Ball at the 31.
Number 19 fires this one over the middle, and it's tipped. Incomplete. Fourth down coming up.
Number 44 came in and got a hand on that football. Left no chance for a reception there.
Well, the knee holds tight on third and long and forces an incompletion. That was a good call by the defensive coordinator.
Oh, it sure was. Perfect D for that situation.
And it will bring up fourth down. Fourth down, and the field goal unit is on the field. Number 80 boots it from 48 yards out and barely misses this one off to the right.
Number 80 misses the field goal here. Let's watch this again. Yep, it's just a little bit to the side of the upright, but close only counts in horseshoes.
The Buccaneers offense will start this drive at their 39-yard line. Bell gets the call on first down and maybe picks up one on the play. Second down with a split backfield. Gets the call again and picks up a couple.
Number 32 with the tackle. Third down.
Williams throws a beauty to the right side, and it's tipped. Incomplete. That will bring up fourth down.
Number 35 knocked that pass down, and he made sure the only one to touch the football was him.
It seemed like the defense read that one from the beginning, and they forced the incompletion with relative ease.
Beautiful call by the D coordinator.
It'll be fourth down. Number 16 gets ready to punt this away. Number 16 gets the ball and pummels this one deep. Number 30 fields the deep punt at the 12. Dragged down at the 18.
And deep by a beauty of a kick there. And by the time he looked up, there was nowhere to go.
The Colts had their last drive stall out at the end. We'll see if they can keep momentum throughout this one, which starts at their own 18-yard line. Number 33 goes in motion. Number 19 zips it to the left sideline, and the catch is made well past the markers for a first down.
Number 33 goes one-on-one on this play and beats his man. He executed that pass pattern perfectly and made the catch. Nice reception. Nope, they could not cover him man-to-man. He was one step ahead of the defense.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and they will move the chains.
And let me tell you, Dan, hearing those chains move is one of the best sounds in the game for an offense.
Puts a lick on the receiver and separates him from the ball. Incomplete.
White didn't let much daylight get between him and his assignment. Nice coverage to force the incompletion.
Potential for some nice yards, but the defense plays it tough. That will bring up second down.
Ball at the Colts, 34-yard line. Rip, 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 rip. Go, go, go.
Number 19 just rifles this one, and the catch is made well past the markers for a first down.
Number 19 zeroed in with the pass back there and leaves the two defenders empty-handed. Good ball placement.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and they will move the chain.
Great execution.
First down, two wideouts on the field. Six picks up about two, and that brings up second down.
Hey guys, they about to pass.
Second and eight. Ball at the 48-yard line.
Number 19 rifles it out left side, and it falls incomplete.
Number 33 had some room on the fringes there, but couldn't reel in the pass.
That would have gotten the first, but it's incomplete, and it will be third down.
Third and eight. Ball at the 48-yard line.
I got 33.
Go, play
more.
Number 44 tips it away on the coverage. Incomplete. It'll be fourth down.
Number 44 came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
That is their fourth batted ball. Tell you, we've seen a number of good defensive plays from this squad.
We sure have. We'll see if they can keep it up, though.
Lee gets ready to punt this away.
To make the return.
Lee gets the snap and punts it away. The Buccaneers have had some trouble moving the ball recently. We'll see what they do on this drive as they start at their own 20-yard line. Number 43 goes in motion. Bell takes his fourth carry of the game and picks up a couple.
Bell stuck close to his blockers, but the play folded quicker than an over-caffeinated origami artist.
And he did a super job of lining up his man and then, pow, taking him down.
That's a great battle down there, Dan. This time, the D won.
Breaks free, finally dropped at the 33. It will be first down.
Williams is dangerous when he ad-libs, Dan. Check it out. Oh, that scramble got him some yards. He was lucky on that one.
First down with the tight end right. This one will fall incomplete. It looks like, we've had an injury down on the field. As soon as we hear anything, we'll be sure to pass the information along to you.
You all right? You all right?
Check this out. You see this right here?
All right?
Feel this?
You all right?
It hurts.
You're going to be all right, man. You're going to be all right.
Let me help you.
Come on.
You got to get back to us. You going to be all right to play?
I got it. Don't worry.
Pass interference. Number 21. Defense. The ball is placed at the spot of the foul.
Number 21, manhandled that receiver back there like a puppy playing with a chew toy, Dan. And he rightly got slapped with defensive pass interference.
First and 10. Ball at the Buccaneers, 38-yard line.
Tackled at the 41.
Second and seven.
Double tight. Bell gets the handoff and passes the line. Stopped at the 44.
Number 83 with the tackle.
Third down, three wideouts in the game. That will bring up first down.
Williams chucked the playbook and improvised for a few, you know, like when I'll improv a catchphrase on the spot, something like, I don't know, can the yams, Martha, that was a doozy.
Miller Jackson back at the 48.
Miller does a great job stopping the quarterback cold in the backfield.
They lose a couple of yards, but it's the feeling of dropping the quarterback that matters.
Right. It's so important to stop and appreciate the little things, like a flower or a rainbow or
a
tortured face on a quarterback, for crying out loud.
That'll be his first sack of the game. Smith gets the sack at the 45.
Smith nails his man behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to cost the offense a few yards. Oh, yeah, that's a great job of getting to the quarterback. Nice sack.
Another good stop by the defense, and that will be two losses in a row. That will end the first quarter, and it's still a scoreless game. Third down, one man down. catches the lob over the middle and tries to get free. Brought down at the 47. Number 30 will be credited with the tackle. Fourth down coming up.
Number 30 shut down the ball carrier just before he got to the markers. A good game, but not good enough.
And Peter, he reminds me a little of a lion laying in the weeds out there waiting to pounce.
And you need cat-like reflexes to bring that guy down. What a matchup.
Number 16 gets the snap and punts it away. Number 46 gathers it up at the 5.
Number 46 manages to catch this very nice punt, but the kicking team is there to make sure the catch is about all he gets. Not much pickup on that run back.
The Colts have been locked in a defensive struggle so far. They will start this drive at their own 6-yard line. Number 71. Him behind the line of scrimmage.
Number 71 was a one-man wrecking crew back there. He powered into the backfield and made the tackle.
That's his second tackle so far. Second down, two receivers to the left. Number 36 gets the call on second down and moves forward for 7.
Number 36 got a little help from his friends on that play, Dan. They gave him the space he needed to make the play. Great blocking up front.
A great job to move the ball and get themselves into a third and short situation. This is a critical play for this drive.
Yeah, now, Dan, they can just fall forward and make the play.
Sounds easy, Peter, but we'll see if they can pull it off. Number 33 catches the heater left sideline, and they convert on third down.
Number 19 threw a nice pass past the coverage and got the completion. Tough throw, but an accurate throw.
Peter, they did what they needed to do, and they squeak it past the first down line.
Yeah, he knew what he needed to do, and he done did it.
How eloquently put.
Thank you.
Number 19 zings it to the right side, and they can't connect. Incomplete. Number 81, shaken up earlier, and I hear Susie Culber has a report for us. Susie?
Thank you, Dan. I just talked to the trainers. They said his forearm is in quite a bit of pain. They're looking at him right now. He seems to be in serious pain. The official word on his return, doubtful. Back to you, fellas.
Thanks, Susie. Second down, tight end to the left. Sacks him back at the 16.
Chambers gets the sack deep in the pocket. That's going to be a sizable loss. Watch this. Oh, yeah. That's going to push him back, way back. Great defensive play.
They read that play the whole way, and they force a third and very, very long.
Yeah, monstrous D the past few downs for these guys.
Number 19 unforks this to the left sideline, and they get the first on third and long.
Number 33 had two guys on him on that play, but still managed to make the catch.
Another completion, and he's definitely shaping up to be a major factor in this game.
It's only the second quarter still, but if he can keep it up, he could have a typically impressive day.
Picks up a yard on the play, and that will bring up second down. Second down coming up on the 10th play of the drive. Number 36 gets the call again, and will end up losing a bunch here. Sacks him way back at the 33. That will bring up fourth down. Lee lines up for the punt.
number 46, to make the return.
Lee takes the snap and pummels this one deep. Number 46 gets it at the 21. Tackled at the 32. It looks like, we've had an injury down on the field. As soon as we hear anything, we'll be sure to pass the information along to you. The Buccaneers offense takes the field and they will start out at their 32-yard line. Loses two, and that will bring up second down.
Smith targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
And I'll tell you, Peter, he made a great tackle there. He brought down one of the more elusive backs in the game.
Well, you're absolutely right, Dan. But if there's one guy on this defense that can stick with the ball and make the play, it was him.
Number zero goes in motion. Bell gets his seventh carry of the game and heads left. Hammered down at the 26.
Number 85 with the tackle.
Bell just gotten into a groove and isn't finding running room anywhere. This has been tough, and he struggled to get 2 yards on seven carries.
Third down.
Number 35 makes a play on this and forces the incompletion. It'll be fourth down.
Number 35 swatted that one away cleanly. The receiver didn't have a prayer in getting that one.
A nice defensive play will give him his second batted ball of the game.
Yeah, great read there.
Number 16 lines up to punt after the three and out. Number 16 takes the long snap and punts it away. Number 30 fields the punt at the 35. Back down at the 47.
Number 30 did a nice job getting some yards after fielding the solid punt.
The Colts have had some problems sustaining drives. We'll see what you hear as they start at their 47-yard line. Number 44 tips it away on the coverage, incomplete. Number 54 had to leave the field earlier in the game, and now Susie Kalber has a report. Susie?
Thanks, Dan. I got a quick word with the trainers, and they said he's got a sprained wrist. They're fitting him with a brace, and they've told me that he will be ready to go back in later in the game. Guys, back to you.
As always, we'll hope for the best up here in the booth. Thank you, Susie. 47-yard line. Number 19 throws a bullet to the flat, and it is not reeled in. Incomplete.
Was the intended receiver. Number 60.
Number 19 knows how to spread the ball around, as you can see by this passing chart. He's getting the ball into his receiver's hands and has piled up 117 yards and no touchdowns.
Third down, 10 yards to go.
Ball with the Colts, 47 yards.
Jefferson grabs the fastball over the middle, and they get the first on third and long.
Jefferson makes the catch with three defenders on his case.
I just don't know why the throw was made into triple coverage. Hey, it worked. Yes, it did. I'm glad he finally nabbed one, because he's had a string of missed catches before this.
Yeah, his quarterback obviously didn't lose faith in him, though, Dan, because he's kept throwing it his way.
Number 19 fires this one over the middle, and the reception is made past the markers for a first down.
number 88. Must be wondering if he's in the twilight zone, Dan. There was absolutely no one there to cover him. It doesn't get much easier than that. Yep, the D must have called the wrong formation, I think. That was a blown play all the way.
Number 33 makes the catch out to the left and picks up four on the play.
Number 19 rolled the dice by targeting a receiver with two defenders near him. But the pass clicked and they'll move the ball.
They move the ball and it will be second down. Second down, two wideouts on the field. Ball at the 20-yard line. Number 34 goes in motion. Number 36 gains 3 yards, and that brings up third down.
Hey, watch the draw!
Third and three. Ball at the 17.
Number 88 makes the nice catch, and they convert on third down.
Number 88 doesn't let a little thing like double coverage stop him from the football.
The balls are coming his way in the middle, and he's making them pay. You have to like his performance so far.
Well, Dan, I like any receiver who's willing to go over the middle and sacrifice the body to make the catch.
This one to the end zone, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Washington managed to disrupt things. He got in there, and he smacked that pass away. Great D.
You know, as a team, they are batting down passes left and right. That is their sixth so far.
Wow, great anticipation of the pass.
Jefferson didn't haul that one in, and it falls incomplete.
White kept both eyes on the short out on that one and caused the incomplete pass.
That'll give us a third down, and the defense was ready for that call.
Well played, and a good job of not giving up the pass.
This one to the end zone, and it's intercepted. Jefferson tackles him for a touchback.
Washington gets the interception, but that really happened because his teammate got in there and tipped it. Oh, it's all about coordinating your defense, man, playing as a team.
Boy, that was a heads-up play to come away with his first interception of the game.
Yeah, you gotta love D like that.
The Buccaneers are going to try and capitalize on the interception. They'll start this drive at their own 20-yard line. Bell will get the carry on first down and picks up a couple.
Number 32 with the tackle.
Bell has been searching for a rhythm out there, Dan, and he's coming up. It seems like his timing is way off. He's working hard, but only has 4 yards on 8 carries.
Second down with the tight end right. Up a yard on the play, and that will bring up third down.
Bell didn't get very far on that last play, and he even had the help of some blocking. I guess the defense had their number.
And boy, that was an excellent job of staying with his man that time to make a good tackle.
Yeah, it looked like a skate drill in practice. You keep your feet moving, zone in, and make the play. Perfectly done. Wow, look at those tackles. That's how you play sideline to sideline.
Grabs the rope right side, and they get the first on third and long.
Number 88 has a guy shadowing him, but still manages to catch.
He beats his man cold. It's all about staking your turf.
That'll be his first catch of the game after being shut out the entire first quarter. This is a bit of a slow start for him.
Yeah, it is, Dan, but he will see the ball more and more as the game goes on.
Rips him down in the backfield, and the clock continues to run.
Number 21 was a one-man wrecking crew back there. He powered into the backfield and made the tackle.
They put a stop to this play behind the line of scrimmage. Pretty good call by the defensive coordinator.
Agreed, Dan. They had it all locked up there.
That will bring up second down. Second down, three wideouts in the game. Number 47 hammers the receiver and forces him to drop the ball. Incomplete.
Number 42 is sitting back in the zone waiting for the pass and then closes enough to force the incompletion. Nice job.
That play would have set up a manageable third and short.
But instead, they force the incompletion. That's how the D is supposed to play.
Could somebody please block me?
The sack, and that takes the Colts take their first timeout. Number 16 gets ready to punt this away.
Number 30 to make the return.
Number 16 gets the ball and punts it away. Number 30 fields it at the 26. Well, Peter, some interesting information up on the screen.
Oh, you bet. All these numbers point to one thing, Dan, a defensive struggle. They can't get complacent. A single score will change the whole complexion of the game. Number 30 did a nice job getting some yards after fielding the solid punt.
The Colts were intercepted last time out. We'll see what happens here. We'll start at their 36-yard line. Rips him down in the backfield, and the clock will continue to run.
Johnson targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
Another tackle, and he's starting to fill up the stat book.
He is dominating, Dan. So far, he's got five tackles and one sack.
Second down and four wideouts in the game. They couldn't connect on this one. Incomplete.
With the deflection.
We stop him right here and right now.
Ball with the Colts, 35-yard line.
Number 88 goes in motion. Number 19 throws a bullet to the flat, and it's off. Incomplete.
You ain't getting nothing.
Lee lines up to punt after the three and out.
Number 46 to make the return.
Lee takes the long snap and pummels this one deep. Number 46 fields the deep punt at the 14. Tackled at the 20.
Number 46 got pinned deep by a beauty of a kick there, and by the time he looked up, there was nowhere to go.
The Buccaneers offense takes the field with the clock at 19. Gets the sack, and the clock will continue to run.
Smith nails his man behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to cost the offense a few yards. Oh, yeah, that's a great job of getting to the quarterback. Nice.
Peter, he's really gotten after the quarterback in this game.
Oh, you can say that again. So far, he's got four tackles and three sacks.
Second down, one man back. That will end the second quarter, and it's still a scoreless game. And now let's send you to Chris Berman in our studios in Bristol for the ESPN Halftime Report. Boomer?
All right, Dan, interesting game at the half. We'll get back to you guys in a bit. First, we welcome everybody to our ESPN Halftime Report. I'm Chris Berman. Now we'll look at our halftime comparison. And as you can see, total yards definitely tell the story thus far. The Colts should be way ahead on the scoreboard, but somehow they've let their opponent hang with them. Let's see if they can change things in the second half. Let's get started on this one early in the first quarter. Number 19 connected with his man on this one. An 18-yard play that set up a Colt field goal, but they couldn't connect. The Colts, midway through the first, the ball at their own 17-yard line. Number 19 would drop back and deliver a strike on this one. The Colts, now early in the second, number 19 would find his target on this one. The Colts, late in the second quarter, number 40 was in the right place at the right time, as his interception was a possible momentum shifter. And that's where we'll leave this one. Colts aren't able to get on the board, and it's a scoreless game. Today's halftime hero has turned in an incredible performance thus far. Number 74 has been unstoppable. So that does it for our halftime report. We'll send you back now to the second half of this one. Dan Stevens and Peter O'Keefe are there. Gentlemen.
Thanks, Boomer, and welcome back to our broadcast presented in ESPN Game Sound. Designed and developed in collaboration with Dolby, the leader in surround sound technology. The Buccaneers will have the ball first to start the second half, and maybe we'll finally see a score in this one. Nothing but a couple of goose eggs on the board. Now let's get to the game. Number 23 decides to take it out of the end zone. Tackled at the 18.
Number 23 got out close to the 20 on that one, so his decision to take it out of the end zone didn't really pay off, but it didn't really hurt him either.
The Buccaneers will start this first play of the drive at their own 18-yard line. Number 43 goes in motion. Up about two, and that brings up second down.
Bell used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
Second and eight. Ball to the Buccaneers. 20-yard line.
Number 56 makes a play on this and forces the incompletion.
Number 56 managed to disrupt things. He got in there and he smacked that pass away. Great D.
On second down, they try for the first, but it's played well by the defense. That will bring up third down.
Nice pressure that time.
Williams throws this one hard over the middle, and it's knocked away from the receiver, incomplete.
Williams was really rolling the dice there by throwing into double coverage. You know, they might have picked him off there.
Now he is 0 for his last three passes, and, you know, you can tell he's starting to get frustrated.
Yeah, all he needs to do is calm down and make the throw.
Number 16 lines up deep in his own territory to punt it away. Number 16 gets the snap and punts it away. Number 30 catches it at the 35. Brought down at the 38.
Number 30 got pinned deep by a beauty of a kick there, and by the time he looked up, there was nowhere to go.
The Colts stalled early last drive, and we'll have to wait and see what happens here. They'll start at their 38-yard line. Chambers gets the sack way back at the 30.
The Buccaneers took him down with only a three-man rush. The protection was weak at best back there.
That will be their fifth sack of the day, and they have been simply relentless so far.
Dan, they haven't let up all game, and that's what you want, somebody whose motor never stops.
It's intercepted. One man to beat. Stop at the 26.
I'm coming now. I'm coming.
Okay, 360 on your back.
Washington not only shanghais the football for the interception, but watch. Gets a few more after the catch. Great play all around. To react, make the catch, and then get some yardage to boot. You can't coach that.
Peter, you couldn't ask for more from today. He has done his part.
And then some. So far, he's got two interceptions.
The Buccaneers offense takes the field, and they are already in field goal position. They'll line up at the 26-yard line. Owens goes in motion. Williams throws this on a rope, and the catch is made at the 11. Finally stopped at the 8. It'll be first and goal.
Williams completes a nice pass past the D on this play. It's worth another look here. Oh, it's all about accuracy, Dan, and there was only one guy covering him on that one, so it makes it an easy catch.
You better bring it, T.O. You better bring it. Stay go back. Stay go back.
This one will fall incomplete.
With the deflection.
They're going air. They're going
second
air.
And goal. Ball at the 8-yard line.
Williams rifles this one to the end zone, and it's caught for the score.
Number 87 is head-to-head on this one with the pass coverage, and the ball is waiting for him downfield. That's a great catch. It's all about being in the right place at the right time, Dan. Perfect execution.
The touchdown was his for the taking, Peter. Good individual effort.
Yeah, and great teamwork, too.
Number 15, Colby.
Here's the extra point, and it's good.
Number six, kicking off for the Buccaneers.
There's the signal, and we're ready. Number six, rockets this one deep. Number 35 downs this in the end zone for a touchback. The Colts have had some trouble moving the ball recently. We'll see what they do on this drive as they start at their own 20-yard line. Number 36 takes it across the line and takes it upfield. Finally gets out of bounds at the 43. First down.
The 36 gives the defense nada to grab onto with this awesome spin move.
Just goes to show you don't always have to bulldoze your way through.
Nope, a well-timed spin or a juke or something, and they can't lay a finger on you.
A beautiful pickup, Peter. Everyone on the offense is happy about that play.
Definitely. Great call by the offensive coordinator.
And it will be a first down. First down from the shotgun. Number 19 takes it to the left sideline, and the completion is good for six.
Number 19 is really struggling out there today. As you can see by the numbers, it's all bad. Up to now, he's got 163 yards and two interceptions.
Double tie, wing left.
Second and three.
Leper,
all
Leper.
At the first, 49 yards.
Number 33 grabs the bullet and as well past the markers for a first down.
Number 19 brings this one perfectly. Great pass, great catch, great play. Let's have another look. Bullseye, what a precise throw. They keep doing plays like this, he could be in big trouble.
Another short pass, and he likes that area of the field so far.
And why not? He's had success there.
Number 19 throws a bullet to the flat, and the reception is made for a pickup of maybe a yard.
Number 19 threaded the ball back there to his man right past all that traffic. Good job.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
Second down, tight end to the left. Number 36 picks up about two, and that will bring up third down.
Number 36 used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
Well, not much of a game there, and they will face third down.
Third and long, too, Dan. Big play coming up.
Number 19 puts his arm into this one, and it's intercepted. Dragged down at the 31.
Oh, check out this replay, Dan. Watch the focus here.
He's got it, and I must say that was some clever maneuvering to get into a position where he could pick it off.
You can't coach instincts like that.
That's their third interception of the game, and Peter, the D is homing in on the passing game.
Yeah, tough play. I love it.
The Buccaneers bring their offense on the field and will start this drive at the 31-yard line. Owens goes in motion. Puts a lick on the receiver and separates him from the ball. Incomplete.
Williams had zone coverage, but throws it into, well, into a couple of defenders. That could have been intercepted.
And Peter, you have to figure that when GMs draft defensive players with a few extra inches to them, this is what they have in mind.
Yeah, you know, back in my day, you'd see guys 5'8", 5'9", back there. But again, that was back in my day.
A different era, as you like to point out. Second down, 10 yards to go.
Bell shows how to play ball in the NFL. He makes the catch and then works for more yards. That's the kind of player you get the ball to.
A nice run after the catch, and that's what they expect from him.
That's his job description. You won't see him running a post route, but you will see him make plays off those shorter catches.
Smith sacks him way back at the 38.
Smith gets the sack deep in the pocket. That's going to be a sizable loss. Watch this. Oh, yeah. That's going to push him back, way back. Great defensive play.
Another sack by this defensive squad, and they have generated, well, some very shocking numbers so far.
I don't know about shocking, but turf eating, yes.
Williams unloads this one to the left, and it's knocked down at the line, incomplete.
Hilton read the play beautifully, smacked that ball down as soon as it got to within reach.
They have really gotten after the ball as a team today. That is their fifth batted ball.
Nice, aggressive D.
Third down and four wideouts in the game. Number 42 makes a play on this and forces the incompletion. That will bring up fourth down.
Number 42 couldn't have read that play any better if it was tattooed on the inside of his helmet.
The defense forces fourth down, and even if they had completed the pass,
it still would have been short.
Yes.
You have to run those routes farther in that situation.
Number 16 gets ready to punt this away. Number 16 takes the snap and pummels this one deep. Number 30 fields the deep punt at the 13. Stopped at the 27.
Number 30 returned for a few there, but after that gigantic punt, it was like tearing a single page out of War and Peace. It doesn't make much of a dent.
Colts have turned the ball over the past two times out. They need to hold on to it as they start this drive at their own 27-yard line. Number 36 gets the handoff and runs into traffic. Lewis tackles him behind the line of scrimmage.
Lewis targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
Peter, he's been lighting up the defensive side of the ball today and getting some nice numbers out of it.
You bet. So far, he's got six tackles.
Second down, three wideouts in the game. Number 19 rifles this one hard over the middle, and it falls incomplete.
With the deflection.
Jefferson grabs the dart right sideline, and they get the first on third and long.
Jefferson has a guy shadowing him, but still manages to make the catch. He beats his man cold. It's all about staking
her. I'm glad he finally nabbed one, because he's had a string of missed catches before this.
Yeah, his quarterback obviously didn't lose faith in him, though, Dan, because he's kept throwing it his way. Well, check out the passing performance here. Talk about yards.
Number 36 goes in motion. Number 19 uncorks this to the left sideline, and it's complete for a first down and a whole lot more.
Number 33 faces down two defenders and comes away with the football. Oh, nice catch.
Nice catch, Peter, and his stats reflect that.
Definitely, Dan. He's now got 96 yards on eight catches.
First down with a split backfield. We'll get the carry on second down and only gets back to the line of scrimmage.
Johnson targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
He's got seven tackles so far. Number 88 hauls it in right side and is at the 15. Touchdown!
Gonna make a great play right here. Snags the football and then really turns on the juice.
That's his first touchdown of the day.
And I think he's a guy you can count on to make those end zone catches. He sets a high standard for himself and he usually meets it.
Get your hands up! Get him up!
Now the extra point, and it's good! There's the signal, and we're ready. Lee kicks this one away. Number 23 catches it back at the one. Dragged down at the 21. Well, Peter, some interesting information up on the screen.
Oh, you bet. Look at how many times they've had to punt it away. They've got to put a few longer drives together and get into the end zone. Number 23 tried to run it out, but the defense preferred that he stayed put, and they made their case pretty forcefully there.
Buccaneers have been locked in a defensive struggle so far. They will start this drive at their own 21-yard line. Bell carries it for the 12th time and picks up a couple.
Bell is really struggling to get any traction, so to speak. No room to run anywhere, and he struggled just to get 9 yards on 12 carries.
Second down, two tight ends in the game. Curtis gets the sack at the 22.
Curtis gets to the quarterback, and nobody lays a finger on him.
And then he proceeds to lay a lot more than a finger on him.
Yeah, he used all 10 and then some.
That'll be his first sack of the game. Williams throws a bullet, and it's tipped. Incomplete. Fourth down coming up.
Number 47 couldn't have read that play any better if it was tattooed on the inside of his helmet.
You know, as a team, they are batting down passes left and right. That is their sixth so far.
Wow, great anticipation of the pass.
Number 16 lines up to punt after the three and out. Number 16 gets the ball and punts it away. Number 30 fields the punt at the 37. Brought down at the 47.
Number 30 did a nice job getting some yards after fielding the solid punt.
The Colts offense takes the field, and they are already halfway there. They'll start at their 47-yard line. Number 36 will get the carry on first down and picks up the first down.
Number 36 finds the hole on this one and gains some good yardage. Wow, great blocking on that play.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and they will move the chains.
And let me tell you, Dan, hearing those chains move is one of the best sounds in the game for an offense.
Jefferson goes in motion. Number 54 tips it away on the coverage, incomplete.
Number 54 with the deflection.
Number 54 came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
Another batted ball, and they have been attacking the pass every chance they get.
That's right, Dan. You know, why simply defend the pass when you can obliterate it?
Number 19 rifles it out left side, and the catch is made well past the markers for a first down.
Number 19 gets it past two defenders on this one. What a throw. It's worth a second look. That's what you call confidence. Throwing into double coverage like that, and what accuracy to boot.
Nice pass, Peter, and he's really lighting up the stat sheet.
Oh, you got it. So far, he's got 262 yards and one touchdown. As you can see, he's up over the century mark. Oh, he came to play today.
Number 36 will take the handoff and gains about 3 yards.
Okay, Carl, we went over this all week in practice. Now we're going to get it this time. And we're going to go just like it is. We're going to execute, and we're going to stay strong, and we're going to get to the spots we need to. Okay, fellas?
So, three quarters in the books now, and we're all tied. Number 36 picks up six on the play, and that brings up third down.
Number 33 with the tackle.
Wow, those are nice stats. Way to carry the ball.
Loose, loose, loose. Number 36 has his number called on third down and barely picks up the first down.
Number 36 played smart and used his blockers to perfection on that last play.
Well, Peter, a pretty nice job there converting on third down.
Yeah, didn't get a lot, but didn't need to. Good job.
First down, and this is the seventh play of the drive. Number 19 fires this one over the middle, and the catch is made well past the markers for a first down.
Number 88 has some company on this play, but he still makes the catch. That's good concentration and focus. It's worth another look. Oh, maybe they should have triple covered him there.
Peter, there's another catch, and for a tight end, he sees the ball quite a bit.
Well, he's one of those guys that's more of a receiver than a tight end, Dan. He's got such great hands that he'll get the ball a lot during this game. Quarterback to the line. Their star tight end getting settled. Here we go.
Number 88 makes the catch. Touchdown!
Come on, give it up, baby.
Number 19 makes a risky pass here and completes it. That took guts, Dan. Check it out. Oh, perfect pass. And it had to be accurate to get in there between the two defenders.
That gives him his second touchdown of the day.
Danny's definitely making his presence felt out there as well as on the scoreboard.
Here's the point after, and it's good. The ref gets the signal, and we're set. Lee booms a beauty here. Number 23 decides to take it out of the end zone. Tackled at the 20.
Number 23 took it out of the end zone, and while it may have been a little risky, he gets out close to the 20, so it all comes out in the wash on that play.
The Buccaneers' offense has taken the field, and they have been having a very tough time passing the ball. They have another opportunity here as they start off at their own 20-yard line. Williams throws this on a rope, and it's incomplete.
Pass interference, number 83, defense. The ball is placed at the spot of the foul.
Hendricks slapped around the receiver way too much on that play, and the ref let him know it with a flag for pass interference.
First and 10. All the Buccaneers, 26-yard line.
Number 43 goes in motion. Bell takes his 13th carry of the game and heads wide right. Stopped at the 30.
Bell has been battling the D, but the D is winning this one. Look at this. No real yards to speak of anywhere. Tough game. He's only got 13 yards on 13 carries.
Second down, two wideouts on the field. Takes it for his 14th carry and gains about 3 yards.
Number 32 with the tackle.
Step it up, D!
Third and three. All the Buccaneers, 32-yard line.
Number 87 catches it over the middle and the ball is loose. And he stopped right there. First down.
Number 43 is going to keep his wits about him here and make a smart play. The ball's loose, but now he gains control. Good reflexes to recover from that bad play.
Coach Dungy doesn't agree with the call, and we're going to see the red flag.
Hey, we want a challenge.
Indianapolis is challenging whether the player had possession prior to the fumble.
This is their first challenge of the game, and even if they lose this one, they still have one challenge left.
Well, Dan, we've got to see if the receiver established possession before he lost the ball. Remember, he has to have full control of it. Well, it doesn't look like he had possession, Dan. I'd call it an incompletion and overturning.
After review, the play has been ruled an incomplete pass. The receiver did not have possession of the ball prior to the fumble. Indianapolis will not be charged a timeout. Fourth down.
He likes the call, and you sort of have a feeling that he knew it all along. Number 16 lines up for the punt.
In punt formation. Number 30 to make the return.
Number 16 takes the long snap and pummels this one deep. Number 30 catches it at the 20. Tackled at the 30.
Number 30 returned for a few there, but after that gigantic punt, it was like tearing a single page out of War and Peace. It doesn't make much of a dent.
Colts will start a drive with the lead for the first time in this game. They'll begin at their own 30-yard line. Number 19 passes this one deep, deep downfield to the right, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Number 33 swatted that one away cleanly. The receiver didn't have a prayer in getting that one.
A nice defensive play will give him his second batted ball of the game.
Yeah, great read there.
Number 44 makes a play on this and forces the incompletion.
Roughing the passer, number 56, defense. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Johnson slammed the quarterback on that play after he released the pass. Hello? You can't do that. That's roughing the passer.
First and 10. Ball at the Colts, 45-yard line.
Number 19 throws a bullet to the flat, and this one is incomplete.
The deflection.
Second down, 10 yards to go.
Ball at the Colts, 45 yards.
No dice, and it falls incomplete.
Jefferson muffed an almost guaranteed catch there, and as a receiver, you have to carry your weight and make the play. They don't come much more catchable than that one.
That's his first drop, and it is not often you see that from him.
No, normally he's pretty sure-handed.
Ball at the Colts, 45-yard line.
Number 19 gets all of his arm into this pass, and it's tipped. Incomplete. That will bring up fourth down.
Number 33 managed to disrupt things. He got in there, and he smacked that pass away. Great deal.
That's his third batted ball, and he is doing his part. That is for sure.
Nice to see aggressive D like that, Dan.
Lee gets ready to punt this away. Lee takes the snap and pummels this one deep. The Buccaneers haven't got much out of their offense recently, and we'll see if they can get back on track here. This drive begins at their own 20-yard line. Bell will take this one off the toss and chews up about four on the play.
Second and six.
Go, 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 go.
3 yards, and that will bring up third down.
Number 78 with the tackle.
Okay, let's go.
We almost got him, baby. He says, step it up.
Three.
Single back. Single
ball
back.
The Buccaneers, 27-yard line.
Williams throws a heater right sideline, and it's tipped. Incomplete. It'll be fourth down.
Number 35 came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
Another batted ball, and they have been attacking the pass every chance they get.
That's right, Dan. You know, why simply defend the pass when you can obliterate it?
Number 16 lines up to punt after the three and out. Number 16 gets the ball and punts it away. Number 30 fields the punt at the 30. Brought down at the 36.
Number 30 didn't have much room to work with back there. The special team squad made sure he couldn't respond to that really nice punt.
The Colts get their offense on the field and will start this drive at their 36-yard line. Number 19 fires this one over the middle, and the reception is made past the markers for a first down.
Look, Dan, great receiving yards there. That will help your fantasy team.
Number 71 gets the sack at the 46.
Number 71 gets a sack in the backfield. The quarterback had nowhere to go on this one. Let's watch. Yep, the D shut the offense down on that play. They couldn't do anything.
He's now got 1.5 sacks on the game. Second down and five wide receivers take the field.
46 yard line.
Number 19 zings it to the right side, and the completion is good for six.
Jefferson was really getting crowded out there with three defenders, but he still made the catch.
Another great catch, and Peter, he's been working that right side of the field with good success.
Yeah, it looks like he's found a weakness, and he's going to exploit it.
Number 33 catches it left sideline, and they get the first on third and long.
Number 19 threw a tremendous cross-field beauty to find his man. That is the definition of arm strength.
That's the third time today he's hit a receiver way downfield.
Well, his arm didn't come cheap for this team, so they might as well get their money's worth. But wow, look at the yardage racked up through the air.
Number 19 just rifles this one, and it falls incomplete.
With the deflection.
Nowhere. Second down from second the shotgun. Number 54 tips it away on the coverage, incomplete.
Number 54 came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
On second down, they try for the first, but it's played well by the defense. That will bring up third down.
Let's nice pressure that time.
There's no fuel left in their tank.
Number 19 unloads this one to the left, and it's tipped. Incomplete. It'll be fourth down.
Number 46 knocked that pass down. Man, he made sure the only one to touch the football was him.
Well, the D holds tight on third and long and forces an incompletion. That was a good call by the defensive coordinator.
Oh, it sure was. Perfect D for that situation.
And it will bring up fourth down. Fourth down and the field goal unit on the field. Number 80 kicks from 37 yards out, and this one is up and in.
Number Number 80 sends it whizzing between the goalposts for a field goal straight down the pike.
There's the signal, and we're ready. Lee rockets this one deep. Number 23 decides to take it out of the end zone. Breaks free, eventually runs out of bounds at the 39.
Number 23 grabs this one deep, then explodes out of the end zone for a terrific run. That's great field position for his team. Call the squad the extra special team.
The Buccaneers' offense is on the field, and they have not produced well at all. They're looking for an answer as they start this drive at their 39-yard line. Number 21 tips it away on the coverage, incomplete.
Number 21 managed to disrupt things. He got in there and he smacked that pass away. Great D.
That had potential for some yards, Peter, but the defense was on top of it and shut it down.
Good denial there.
Second down coming up. Williams uncorks this to the left sideline and it's incomplete. Third down, three wideouts in the game. Now, chews up 4 yards, and that brings up fourth down. Williams really rifles this pass. It falls incomplete. They will turn the ball over on down.
Williams had zone coverage, but throws it into, well, into a couple of defenders. That could have been intercepted.
Peter, that seemed like an odd situation to go for it on fourth down. What do you think?
Well, it was very gutsy, but maybe they should have used their heads and not their digestive system on that one.
How was that?
You know, guts.
Gutsy.
Digestive.
Got it.
All right.
The Colts are in control, but it's far from over. The offense comes out and will start this drive at the 42-yard line. Number 36 is his number called on first down and maybe picks up one on the play.
Number 54 with the tackle.
Second down, tight end to the left.
Ball at the 41.
Number 36 cruises out to the left side and chews up about 4 on the play. Number 36 carries it for a third time in a row and converts the third and long.
Number 36 has a great offensive line in front of him. They made that play happen. Yep, those blockers opened up the hole for him. A huge game.
Nice play, and they will convert on third.
Great execution, Dan. They did everything right.
First down, and they line up with three tight ends. First down, 10 yards to go. Number 36, the Buccaneers take their first timeout. Second down. The clock is stopped at 1:56. Number 36 picks up the Buccaneers will take a timeout. That's their second. Third down and four wideouts in the game. Number 36 gets the toss and gets past the line. The Buccaneers take a timeout. That's their final one. Fourth down, and the field goal unit is on the field.
Number 15, Colby.
Number 80 with the 43-yard attempt, and he misses this one to the right.
Number 80 misses the field goal here. Let's watch this again. Yep, it's just a little bit to the side of the upright, but close only counts in horseshoes.
The Buccaneers start this drive of the game from well in their own territory, and the clock at 1:42. Williams floats this one out to the right sidelines, and it's off, incomplete. Second down. The clock is stopped at 1:38. Logan makes a play on this and forces the incompletion.
Logan came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
Another batted ball, and they have been attacking the pass every chance they get.
That's right, Dan. You know, why simply defend the pass when you can obliterate it?
Third down, one man back. Williams uncorks this to the left sideline, and it's knocked away from the receiver, incomplete. They will forfeit the ball on downs.
Rhino, Rhino!
Oh, second and 11.
I got 33.
Ball 35.
I got 19.
Come on, Colts! Let's get the first down! why don't you just join the practice squad?
Randy. 6 yard line.
And that is going to do it for this one.
The Colts
come out on top 17-7. For my partner, Peter O'Keefe, this is Dan Stevens saying goodbye until next time.
All right, gang, great work as always. And with that, we welcome everybody back to the ESPN studios for our ESPN Video Games post-game show. I'm Chris Berman. Stepped it up for sure, putting up some good numbers. Let's get started in this one early in the third quarter. Number 40 would come up with the big play to kill a drive as he was able to step in front of a wayward pass for an INT. The Bucs have it off an interception already in the red zone. Number 12 would put this pass right where it needed to be. An 8-yard touchdown for the Buccaneers. Colts back by 7. Number 44 shows some great awareness here as he gets himself into position to pick this one off. The Colts have it again. Number 88 found a soft spot on the defense and it worked to his advantage. A 19-yard touchdown for the Colts. Game tied, 7-all. Number 88 did his part by getting himself open on this one. A 1-yard touchdown for the Colts. This time at the 49-yard line, number 19 would find his target on this one. That set up a 38-yard field goal. Not a lot of action after that, and that's where we end up. Colts come away with a win, 17-7. Now let's catch up with the player who really ignited his team's offense with his deft passing and has earned our Player of the Game award. Number 19 is on the sidelines with Susie Colbert. Susie?
Thank you, Chris. You transcended the competition today, and you were instrumental in helping your team snag the win. What put you guys over the top?
Both teams came out ready to play today. Luckily, we were able to come up with some big key plays down the field, and luckily we came out on top.
Chris, back to you.
That winds up our broadcast of the NFL preseason on ESPN, worldwide leader in sports for 25 years and counting. I'm Chris Berman. Thanks for joining us.